नाम श्रेष्ठं मनुमपि सचीपुत्रमत्र स्वरूपं रूपं तस्याग्रयुरिपुरीं मातरीं गोष्ठवाटीं राधाकुण्डं गिरिवरमहो राधिका माधवासं प्राप्तो यस्य प्रथितकृपया श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीनाय पराधलक्षै क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्द यं प्राव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदो तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि त्वैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे त्वं न मां चरणन्ति So I have explained first sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, also third sloka. First sloka was Janamadasya jata annayadi taratasya abhikyo saratateni brahmrida jyad kavai muhyanti jat suraya तेजो वारि मदंग यथा विनिमयो जत्र त्रिसर्गो अमृषात् धामना स्वैन निरस्त कोहकम सत्यम परम धीमहि दिस इज मंगलाचरण ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवत होल श्रीमद् भागवत दिस श्लोक कवर्स होल श्रीमद् भागवत I think that the whole Srimad Bhagavat, rest Bhagavat, is explanation of this one sloka. Everything, like a seed, is in this. All the pastimes of Krishna and his devotees are in this. I explain tomorrow, yesterday, something, but I'm still telling something more. So I told that Janmadasya Jataha. From Krishna, whole creation has come. Also, Adiras, Madhuras has been come from Radha and Krishna together. So Radha and Krishna both are Satyam Parama Dhimahi. Dhimahi means meditate. That Krishna and Radha should come in my heart. No? Who are they? Satyam Parama Satyam Dhimahi. I meditate them. That they should come and they should manifest themselves as they are in my heart. How they are? I told about Anvaya and Vyatirek. Same thing Anvaya and Vyatirek. Only some difference of words only. I remember something that some devotees are there who are telling that Narayan Maharaj is telling some different thing from our Gurudev Srila Prabhupada. I admit this. I'm telling some different. What different? He told that you should speak his truth. I told that you should not tell lie. Certainly there is a very big difference. He told that you should utter Krishna. I am telling that you should utter Krishna, being pure, having relation with Krishna, giving up worldly attachments, all kinds of aparads, offenses and attachment. Very big difference, you see. So many words I am telling and he is telling only one. He is telling that you should drink water. I am telling that you should not take dirty water, drink pure water. So much difference? So I think that no difference at all. I can tell very boldly and strongly that there were about 100 sannyasis of Swamiji. But I think that most of them have gone in worldly life. They were very learned persons. I challenge them all that what Swamiji was telling, they are telling same thing in same word. They cannot. Anyone cannot tell. The difference of word will be there. So we should look after interior motive. What is the object of his telling and object of others? Rupa Goswami has told in some words in Bhakti Rasa Amrita Sindhu and Ujjwal Nilmani, you know. Then why Jiva Goswami and Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has explained in so many words? Why? There are some difference, but not difference. To illuminate a thing, they are telling in so many words, but the object and the internal Krishna love is there, one thing. We know that there is some difference of words between Baldev Vidyabhushan and Jiva Goswami in a philosophy, Vaishnava philosophy, so much. These are not differences. These are called Vaishishtya.
Speciality.
This is called. Same thing. So anyone cannot tell like this that we are, I'm telling different and he's telling different. There must be some difference of words. So no harm. So here, Anvaya and Vyatirek, same thing is being told in what? Anvaya.
Direct and indirect.
Don't tell lie and tell truth. Same thing. Here, prema has been divided into two. If there is no separation mode, no pleasure of meeting. So, the separation mode adds the happiness of meeting. So, though both they are seen as a different thing, but actually they are one thing. Two sides of same prema. No? So, if there is no separation mood, then this meeting will be not of high class. Some devotees in Vrindavan of Nimbark Sampradaya or other Sampradaya, Radha Ballavi Sampradaya, they always want to meet Krishna, always with him. No separation mood. But it is absurd. Srimad Bhagavat does not tell like this. In Srimad Bhagavat we see so many things like Venu Geet, Gopi Geet, Bhramar Geet, or all Jugal Geet,
Pranay Geet.
These are all in separation moods. Gopis are abusing Krishna, telling him dhurta, lumpat and so many things. Krishna wants, and Krishna came in the shape of
Bambubi
to hear all these things. And he told, admitted that I heard everything. And I became pleased. Brahma cannot please me by doing
prayers
and by faith, stuti, sham, gan and all. But gopis abusing to me pleases me very much, so much. So this is Anna and Bhitire. In Srimad Bhagavat both has been told. Arthesu abhikyaha. Brahma obeys the order of Krishna and he creates this universe, Brahmand. But actually, he cannot do. He only do vastuon ko jodta hai. He joins the parts of anything. All parts have been made in any company. And in India we have
Hind Motor
in Calcutta. She exports parts from America, England, so many parts, engine from there, some parts from here, some parts there, and they join it and they make motor. Actually, they are not doing so. Only they are connecting some parts. So Brahma is doing like that, not creating. Only he joins the parts. He cannot do, an ant he cannot make. Nothing he can cut. Even any soul he cannot make. So Arthesu Abhigya, only Krishna, Supreme Personality of Krishna, is powerful to do anything. And he is free, quite free. Abhigya Swarat. Anyone cannot control Krishna. Why Krishna made this? Why Krishna made me like conditioned soul? And someone he made liberated soul. Why? Because he wishes. Why he should not do? Why he should not do? He must do like this. He has created so many things, he has created also like this. You cannot imagine. Why Krishna managed to have any association for anyone and not for other? No facility. Why? Actually, Krishna does not do. He is so merciful. So in Shastra it has been told that if Vaishnava is doing kripa, mercy to any Vaishnava, it is not Krishna who does it, but that Vaishnava, Madhyam Adhikari. If we tell that why Krishna is merciful to that person, why? Not to others. He gave Putana, he made Putana his mother in Golok, like mother. Dhatri Uchit Gati. Why? Why he could not give Agasur, Bakasur and all other? To them he gave only liberation. But not like
Putana.
Why? Agasur has not done anything. Why Krishna gave him salvation? Only the relation of Putana was there. That he made his shape like a mother. And Krishna did it. Ram cannot do, Nrisimhadeva cannot do, anyone cannot do. So Krishna is so merciful. If tene brahma hridaj adakabaye, tene brahma hridaj, he gave knowledge of chatushloki bhagavat to Brahma, and thus he gave him the knowledge who is Krishna, who is Jeev, who is Brahma, what is Maya, what is Yog Maya, what is called Bhakti. He gave everything. And he manifested Vedas in the heart of Brahma. Tene Brahma Hrida. Also the meaning is another also. What? Tene Brahma Hridaj Adkabai. Adkabhi is Sukhdev Goswami. Tene Brahma. What? Brahma Rasa, Rasa Brahma. That's Srimad Bhagavat. In the heart of Adi Kavi is Sukhdev Goswami. So, Rasa Brahma he manifested in the heart of Sukhdev Goswami. That is, he was able to tell all these pastimes in a very good way. Like nectar. Otherwise, he was not able to tell all this Krishna Katha. Tene Brahma Hridaj Adakabai. Tene Arasha Brahma, in the heart of Rupa Goswami, and he was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is why he has made Ujjwal Nilmani Bhakti Rasami Sundu. And by reading these books, by hearing these books, anyone can test Srimad Bhagavat, otherwise not. Anyone can't be qualified to understand Srimad Bhagavat without the help of Rupa Goswami's book. So many persons have made tika,
commentary
on Srimad Bhagavat. But it was not so good as Srila Sanatana Goswami did, Srila Jiva Goswami did, Srila Chakravarti Thakur did. So, it is due to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Why? Because he is Srimati Radhika and Krishna both. Krishna has taken the shape and beauty of Krishna, golden collar of Srimati Radhika, both. And then they have manifested this ocean of rush in the heart of Adi Kavi Rupa Goswami. You can question how he is adhikavi. Only 400 some years or 500 years before, Rupa Goswami is here. He was in this world. How he can be the first kavi? Brahma, we can tell Brahma is first kavi. But I know that he is more superior than Brahma. He can teach Brahma 100 and lakhs births. He is more superior. Because he is the associate of Krishna himself and Radhika, Rupa Manjari, and also the associates of Srimad Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Brahma cannot go so high. Even Lalita Vishakha, they cannot enter in a very secret place where Radha and Krishna is playing. But for Rupa Manjari, Rati Manjari, it is very easy to serve at that time also. Fanning, giving chamar, where they are doing like this, oh, they will, oh, Rupa Manjari, come on and give me fan. If Rupa Manjari is there, Srimati Radhika is in Kunj, she can tell, oh, Krishna, don't come. Or Swaminiji, don't want. So you should be out of this Kunj. She can do like this. So Brahma cannot touch the lotus feet of, lotus dust of Rupa Manjari. So it is with Siddhant, bona fide Siddhant, that Adi Kavi is Rupa Goswami, no harm. So this meaning is more appropriate. Tene Brahma Hridaya, how to serve Krishna in conjugal? From beginning, Anya Abhilashita Sunyam, from this slope, and to end of Ujjvalinmani. Ujjvalinmani and Bhakti Rasami Sindhu are one book. Only first part, second part. No two books. So if you will not follow Rupa Goswami, Bhakti Rasami, Sindhu and all this, you cannot understand ABCD of prem and love, how to serve Krishna. One day you will have to go through, you will have to hear all these things. Someone, I was reading today the Nectar of Instructions. On 8th slok, I saw something and became very pleased, became very happy. He is telling Rupanuga there. What is Rupanuga? How to, our object should be Rupanuga, bhajan. He has told everything there.
Who?
Swamiji explained. I will bring tomorrow, if I am having some time in morning class for 15 minutes, I will tell you to read that thing. Very, very. He has told everything what I have never told. He has told so many things, secret things. He has told 5 stages, Shravandasa, Varandasa, Smarana Dasha, Bhavapan Dasha, and Sampatti Dasha. You know all these things? You are telling that, oh, Narayan Maharaj is telling different from Swamiji. But I think that I have not told all these things that Swamiji has especially told. And if you are not doing, he has told for new-fide devotees, not for all these things, for new devotees. Shravandasas must be. If there is no Shravandasa, how you can burn? How you can do kirtan? How can you
meditate?
You cannot do anything. So it has been told in Bhakti Rasami Sindhu. He was in the line of Rupa Goswami, I have told you. And if you will read the explanation of first slok, from Swamiji. We will see that what I am telling, he has written more clearly all these things. I have no language to explain, but he was so much learned. So he can explain. He had explained all things. He had never warned anyone that you should not hear the name of Raga and Muga. He has told that you should practice, not hear only of this word. Don't be nervous. And that is why those who are not hearing these words, no testing bhakti, and they are going down again where they are. This is the reason. Because they are not testing anything better than what they have in beginning. Bhakti is like a current. It must flow. If there is no flow, no advancement. The water will be rotten. So, if there is no taste in chanting, remembering, meditating, how we can advance? And that is why they are not proceeding towards this and they are going falling down. They are telling that, oh, Narayan Maharaj is Sahajiya. But I have not fallen. But why they are falling all? If I am Sahajiya, I should not tell all these things. I am telling Rupanuga, Ragatmik Bhakti and all other things. I am telling Krishna Katha so sweetly. But I am not falling down. What I was about 60 years before, I am so much testing and I am more happy.
You are sitting up. How we can
fall down? Then, Adikabaye mut yanti jat suraya tejo bar midang jathabhimayo jatati sorgo amrisha. Tejo bari, mridang. In this world we are seeing three things. Earth, water and fire. Fire is the example of chit sakti. No? Fire is not seen everywhere, but anything rubbed, then fire comes. Like
friction.
If you will give a stone on another, any stone, then it will come fire. There are two woods, mix them like this, fire will come. So by bhajan sadhan, this chit sakti is realized. This prem of Krishna, Krishna prem is realized. Without sadhana we cannot see. The soul is also like this. Soul is here, everywhere. But we cannot realize without sadhana. So this is the example of chit sakti, fire, tejo, vari, water. Water has two conditions. If it is too cold, then it becomes ice. And if it is in its natural state, then liquid. If souls are in natural states, serving Krishna, they are liberated, always serving Krishna. And if by any cold, so much cold, then they will become like
ice.
So, if you are forgetting Krishna, going very far away from Krishna, far away means forgetting Him, then our nature will be changed and then we will be liberated, conditioned soul. So much attraction for worldly things. In pure Atma, soul, only attraction for Krishna is there, only service is there. But now, we cannot be without what? Right. Kya kar? Attachment.
Attachment.
Is kamukta?
Lusty. Attachment.
Some person like in this, I cannot be without loss. Like,
lust.
I should must be with lady or husband. But in pure state, only the charm, only the attraction of Krishna. Here only means attraction for Krishna and his associates or worshipable being is only Radha and Krishna both. So there are two conditions of soul. It by example of water. Water has sometimes condensed, sometimes natural way. And mridang, this earth, it can shape, we can shape in any way, pot, like dogs, hogs, cows, we can make from earth. So this body, creepers and animals and all things like this, no difference at all in anything. But there is also very deep meaning. Tejo bhari mridang yatra binamaya. Here tej, what is the meaning of tej? Come to Brahma Gayatri. Bhuvasva tat savitur varanyam varga devasya. Varga devasya means, varga means tej there also. Here varga means power, attribute. Who is he? Who is she? Srimati Radhika herself. If you are not worshipping Srimati Radhika as a power of Krishna, you cannot realize anything, anything. Whole world has been created by Srimati Radhika, not by Krishna. Not by Krishna. How? Krishna only wishes, and all actions, cultivations comes from Srimati Radhika, actually. We see that Krishna has lifted Govardhan, but actually Krishna has not lifted. Who lifted? By left side of Krishna. Left hand, and in left hand,
left
this left, most left. So Srimati Radhika is always in the left of Krishna. So see, only Krishna wished, but all actions, cultivations, everything is from Srimati Radhika. So here tejo var mridam yatra binmayo trisargo amrisha. This world seems like true, but this world is not true. And we realize it true, and that is why we are attached in this worldly thing. But if you know that we are part and parcel of Krishna, you are eternal servant, by the mercy of any realized soul, then we will have no attachment on this. Like Sukadeva Goswami, Narada Rishi, like the associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You know Raghunath Das Goswami? Her wife was so much beautiful at that time in whole world. Vishnu Priyaji. But he left at once. Vishnu Priyanam. Raghunath Das Goswami. He left his wife. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all associates did like so. You know Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur? He was in Vrindavan. His guru told that you should go to your wife and take permission, and you should come here in Vrindavan, and then you should do bhajan. To carry order of his Gurudev, he went. And his wife came. in a very solitary room, they were sitting, whole night Krishna Katha was going on. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was telling. So beautiful, sweet pastimes of Krishna, whole night gone. And then he came to again Vrindavan. He asked her wife that, may I go to do bhajan? Yes, you can go. No charm at all. So Vaishnavas are like this. If anything charming in this world, how he can have charm towards Krishna? We will have to cut down all this. Vaishnavas like a very, sharp sword, they cut all these things. This Krishna, creator of this, he creates. He enters in this world like Paramatma, everywhere. Like Brahma, he is all over world. But he has manifested so many, Ram, Baradev, Nishinghadev, so many incarnations. But still, he, with his power, Srimati Radhika and Gopis and Gopi, always with a very beautiful Natavar Shyamasundar roop, having his float on his lips, very beautiful. He always lives in Golok Vrindavan Dham. So I am praying, Satyam Parama Dhimahi. He has told in next sloka, I will explain further. You should be any Kirtan. And after that. One Kirtan? In short, I want to tell that in Gita, it has been told in the last sloka, Sarva Dharman, not last sloka, but last chapter. Instruction. Sarva Dharman Uparityajya, Mam Ekam Saranam Vraja, Aham Tvam Sarva Papebhyo Mukshishyami Mahasucha. Perhaps all you know the meaning of this sloka. Giving up all the dharms, really they are not dharm, outwardly dharm of sarir, this body and mind. You should take shelter, offer yourself in the lotus feet of Krishna. That is saranagati. And this is called in Gita best thing, to surrender. This Saranagati has been told topmost in Gita. But in second sloka of Srimad Bhagavat, see what is written. Dharma prajyata kaitavo attar paramo nirma saranang satang vedyam vastam atrivasto sivadam tapatrayonumulanam Srimad Bhagavate mahamuni krite kimba parairishvara Saddo hridya varudyate kritibhi susvi tatkhanat. In this sloka, in brief I am telling that it has been told that if anyone